good evening. This is Warrior Empowerment Hour, Mr. Too Easy. So, guys and girls just tuning in, hey, thanks for tuning in and Happy New Year to you if I haven't told you. And if you're looking outside your window right now, so you see, depending on what state you're in, there's some snowflakes falling. But definitely be safe out there. Make sure you have a warm blanket in the car, some flares, some lights, batteries, and some water. You never know, so maybe some jumper cables. So that's just something, you know, I used to do back in the day and I still do now. So just in case, because you never know how, when you're going to and from, if there's going to be an accident, if the traffic's going to be backed up. Just like, you know, I drove up here from Chambersburg on Route 11, and there was like five fire trucks on Route 11 at one of the houses right past, Nellie Fox. So, you know, they had it down to not really one lane, but you was using the middle lane to kind of come down, I guess this is going south, yeah, southbound. So, you know, but I left in more than enough time and it's pretty good. So definitely make sure you get some gas while you're out too. Whether it's a dollar in there, $2, $10, just put a little fuel in there, you never know. So of course, we're gonna talk about today. It's gonna be intrusive thoughts, prevention, suicide thoughts, and prevention. But before we get into it, let me tell you what happened this past couple weeks because I've been out. So of course, I've been out because there's a lot going on in the world, you know. The thing that happened at the Capitol, let's see what else. The Capitol, the soldiers at the Capitol that was, you know, sleeping inside in the building and in the garage, stuff like that. I'll talk a little bit about, I won't talk a whole bunch about that part. But there's so much going on. So, you know, we try to stay positive here on WRGG 93.7 because we are GA, your community radio station. So I got to do a few, a live meeting with Blackout, Chuck Tenbrook. You know, if you want to follow him, that's blackoutinc.org. You know, he's the one with the big black semi-trailer, tractor-trailer truck that has the flag, over 14 flags on that thing. For the fallen, for the present, for the veterans, for first responders, for all. It's a wonderful truck. He's doing bigger and better things. So it's going to be wonderful. So definitely follow Blackout. He has a YouTube channel. He's on Facebook. And he has a webpage, which is www.blackoutinc.org. So definitely click on there, see the story, donate if you can. I know they're going to start some hashtags. So there's a few hashtags that's going out now is hashtag Blackout. When he's traveling, because he's going to be going to Daytona, he's going to be going to Oregon, he's going to be doing a lot of stuff, so definitely follow him. So one hashtag is they're going to have is I See You Blackout. So hashtag I See You Blackout, take a picture of the vehicle when you see it on the highway, and bam. And that way you kind of trace where he's going and get the momentum going, because he's out there supporting the veterans and supporting the first responders and supporting our current military now. Okay, so next thing, mark your calendars. We have 26, June 26, 2021. There'll be Freedom Team Inc. will be having a battle of the bands at Post 224 AMVETS in Chambersburg, Pennsylvania. So it's supposed to start at noontime and probably end around 8 or 9. So it's going to be a battle of the bands. More to come. There's a lot of information out there. Definitely, you can follow them at www.freedomteaminc.org. It's a wonderful veterans nonprofit group. I'm sorry, I should know this. Freedom Team is a nonprofit 501c3 that supports the veterans, the caregivers, as well as the children and the community. So they have a few programs. I'll mention those in a few right after I finish this second one. So the second event they're having is a fashion gala on July 31st. That's going to start at 5 for VIP entry and then 6 for regular general admission. So it's going to be basically, in layman's terms, a fashion show. Come as you are, dressed to impress, you know. It doesn't make a difference how you come. Just come on in. It's going to be some wonderful food, some wonderful music, and some wonderful fashions from some wonderful ladies and men that's going to walk down that catwalk and guess what? Show you everything that's happening from 2020 to 2021. And it's going to be wonderful. So definitely come out to that. We're going to have a silent auction out there. There's a wonderful veteran that's out of the Lancaster area that does silent auction with sports memorabilia. So he'll be coming out there with that stuff. Hey, what's going on, Ricky? So other than that, you know, definitely come on out and support that. And definitely, let's see, and also Freedom Team would also like to do a spotlight for Mason-Dixon Warrior Adventures. Okay, so Mason-Dixon Warrior Adventures is a wonderful nonprofit, and they basically do hunting and fishing for all active duty, all veterans. That's basically in Pennsylvania. And I know they say Franklin County and Washington County and some other stuff in Hagerstown, but they people come from all around. It's a wonderful organization. They just had a October pine tree deer hunt, and one of the service members shot a 31 point buck, and it was over 300 inches long. Now that was a great adventure. So, you know, if you want to put your money behind something, you know, other than these other two groups, you know, Mason-Dixon Warrior Adventures is a wonderful organization. They can be reached at www.mdwa.us. So M stands for Mason, D stands for Dixon, W stands for Warrior, and A stands for Venture.us. So definitely follow them. They have a lot of events come up. A few events was canceled due to COVID because they get a lot of their active duty members from Walter Reed. So they did have a few events, you know, come up. They had to cancel, but they're still working. Trust me, these guys and girls have volunteers that's working around the clock and trying to make sure that every single person that would like to go on a hunt or a fishing trip can go. So definitely please support them. They also support Freedom Team. So it's a wonderful thing, and it's a big circle. It really is a big circle, you know. So a lot of the nonprofits, especially when it supports veterans, a lot of them it's a big circle. So they help out each other. So it's great. It is wonderful. So let me tell you a little bit about Freedom Team that people may not know. So Freedom Team is stationed is out of Maine, Pennsylvania, and North Carolina, and we're trying to get Virginia also. So what Freedom Team does is basically helps out veterans, their family, with the caregiver and the children, because with the spouses and the children, there's also secondary PTSD. So we make sure that the children get all the resources they need, whether they need doctor's appointments, whether they need to go out on adventures, whether they need to play video games, whatever they need to do to kind of feel better about certain things, okay? Not to say the children don't feel better, but it's just certain circumstances have certain problems, okay, or certain issues, stuff like that. But they definitely help that out. Then they also help out the community. So far, what have they done in Franklin County is they have started what they call Feast, Friends Eating and Sharing Together Feast. Okay, so right now on Mondays and Wednesdays, so far they give out free food at the Southgate Shopping Center in Chambersburg, Pennsylvania. The last 2 days, the last two Mondays and Wednesdays, they've went out to, York, PA, at Market Street Bridge, because they found a lot of homeless out there. So these are prepackaged sandwiches and snacks from Starbucks, salads, parfaits, all that stuff. They donated the last two times they went to the Market Street Bridge down in New York area and was given some food out there. Because, hey, you know what the weather's like. So these guys and girls out there really need it bad, so they definitely shared the wealth. So and then their objective is every quarter is to have a feast meal. So, and that's free to the public. Just come in, and they're looking for places to do it at, whether it's going to be the AMVEST, American Legion, Scotland Community Center. It can be anywhere. So once the COVID kind of lifts some of the restrictions, then you'll see more events for them to do in person. Okay, especially like a dinner, because some people may not want to come out, and, you know, not to say, you know, there's anything negative, but, you know, everyone has their own little thing, so, you know, but they're looking to do that. They also reached out and was looking to see if they want to do, to go a feast as well, but then that's going to, you're going to still need a kitchen and stuff like that, so they're looking into that, because that may cost a little bit more, because then you have to do to-go containers instead of just regular paper plastic. But to-go container is a little bit more expensive than getting a whole box of 2,000 styrofoam plates and stuff. So, but they're looking into that. Also, they have Freedom Farm Team. So what they do is they teach you to farm to table. So they have these planter boxes, and basically, no matter where you may live at, they make sure there's a box that's made for your situation. So if you live in a city, if you live in a rural area, if you live out on a farm, you know, stuff like that, or in the suburbs, you know, they make sure, you know, they come out, assess the situation, see what your needs are, and they kind of show you how to, you know, plant your average crops, create a planter box, and, you know, have that purpose to go out there and plant that seed, cultivate it, water it, do everything you need to do, and then guess what? Say you do tomatoes. Guess what? The tomatoes will start coming out there. You can start picking those tomatoes off. Guess what? Instead of going to the supermarket getting tomatoes, now you just grew a bunch of tomatoes. Same with potatoes. Same with cucumbers. Same with carrots. You know, with bok choy, with lettuce, with everything, with any kind of green, any kind of vegetables. So it's going to be pretty wonderful. That one is great. They've done it in North Carolina. They've done it in Maine. So now we're going to do it in Pennsylvania. There's some big things coming down the pike. So that's why they're having these two major events, which is a fashion gala on July 31st and a battle of bands on June 26th. Because those two fundraisers are going to help fund these two things, as well as doing things with Mason-Dixon Warrior Adventure. Because I know Freedom Team wanted to do an axe throwing competition event, and then they also wanted to do just, you know, showing people how to use firearms safely and, you know, go to the range and do some stuff like that. So of course that takes donor dollars, that takes funding. Excuse me. So that's why they're having these events, and there's gonna be more events coming down the pike, so definitely beware. And you know, we're gonna try to pass the positive word as much as we can. You know, as long as people have something positive to do, we're definitely gonna be pushing it out there. So right before I get into it, let me play a wonderful song. Let's see what kind of song we're gonna look for today. You know, it's a wonderful day outside, you know, and this is right before the month of February. So, you know, Valentine's gonna be coming up soon. So you know what, let's play some Diamond Rio, Meet in the Middle. And if you know the song, sing along, tap your feet, shake yourself, and have a wonderful time. So this is Diamond Rio.
It's caught in the crossfire.